Welcome to chemistry online class. Next we are moving into other topic, structure and bonding in metal olefin. To explain structure and bonding in metal olefins, one example I am taking, that is GCS salt. In today class I am going to discuss GCS salt and its preparation, structure and bonding in GCS salt. Let's move on to introduction. The GCS salt is first organometallic compound having olefin as a ligand. It was synthesized by William Gies. The formula of GCS salt is potassium trichloroethylene platinate monohydrate. In GCS salt, the complex is associated with a negative charge, that is anionic complex. Let's move on to synthesis of GCS salt. GCS salt was prepared by refluxing ethyl alcohol with K2PtCl6. After refluxing, addition of KCl solution gives light yellow color crystals of GCS salt. This is also can be prepared by another method, by taking K2PtCl4. I have written here. Reacting with ethylene molecule in alcohol, alcoholic HCl or alcohol SnCl4 gives GCS salt. These are some of the methods for preparation of GCS salt. Next, we are moving into structure of GCS salt. The geometry of GCS salt is square planar geometry. In the square planar geometry, center of the square is occupied by the platinum metal. Three corners are occupied by chlorine atom. And the fourth corner is occupied by ethylene ligand. So if you look at here ethylene ligand, the distance between the carbons and platinum, both the carbons and platinum, is equal distance. That means these two carbons are equidistant to platinum. So when ethylene is a planar molecule, when it is approaching the platinum, ethylene molecule is there in the perpendicular to molecular plane and hydrogen is oriented away to the metal. In the structure I have represented, hydrogens are away to the platinum center. This is about the structure of the GCS salt. Let's move on to the bonding. In GCS salt, three chlorine atoms donates electrons and form coordinate covalent bonds. But interesting thing we have to discuss with respect to the alkenes. So when the alkene ligand is present, how the bonding pattern exists in the molecule, that we have to discuss. To explain bonding pattern in alkenes, metal alkenes, we are taking a model called Dewar model. Dewar explains the bonding in alkene complexes such as GCS salt based on MOT theory, molecular orbital theory. So when we are looking at metalloalkene complexes, there are two parts. One is formation of dative bond, dative sigma bond. Another one is formation of pi back bonding. Let's discuss one by one. First we focus on formation of dative bond or formation of sigma bond. That ligand donates its electrons to metal, which forms sigma bond. Ethylene is pi electron ligand, and here ethylene molecule, the pi bond is formed between two carbons by sideways overlapping. And same structure here I am mentioning. These two are electron cloud distributed above and below. Now these pi electrons are donated to the empty orbital of metal. This is empty orbital. The formation of sigma bond is taking place due to overlapping of empty metal orbital with pi orbital of alkene ligand, which forms dative sigma bond. The pi electron shifted to empty metal orbital. So electron donation from the filled pi orbitals to vacant metal orbital forms sigma bond. Let's move on to pi backbonding. How the backbonding is taking place in metal alkene systems. Here, in the previous case, we have seen ligand is donated to metal. Now in this backbonding, it is reverse. Metal will donate to empty orbital of ligand. How this process is taking place is, let us assume this is metal d orbital and these are filled metal d orbital, which transfer electrons to empty orbital of ligand, alkene ligand. And where this empty orbitals is present, now previous case we have seen those are bonding orbital. Now you can see these are anti-bonding orbital of alkenes, which are empty. So empty orbitals are associated with the alkene system and filled orbitals are associated with the metal. Now metal filled electrons are donated to empty orbital of ligand as a result, which forms pi bond, and this we call it as pi back bond. The sigma bond is ligand to metal. In back bonding, metal to ligand electron shifting is taking place. So overlapping will take place between the filled metal orbital and empty ligand orbital. Let's see complete this pattern in molecular orbital diagram. Now I am showing a molecular orbital diagram for this bond formation. Let's take this is metal filled orbital, filled d orbital, which is having lower energy. Now let us assume I kept here electrons. These are empty orbital of metal. Now this is pi bonding and this is pi star anti bonding, so which can forms a pi bond. This we are taking a pi orbital and this is anti bonding orbital, lobes are opposite pi star. Now the first case, sigma bond formation. The sigma bond formation is there between the ligand filled orbital to empty orbital, which overlap, which forms a sigma d2 form. This is sigma d2 bond formation. The next one is backbonding. Backbonding is between filled orbital with empty orbital of alkene, which forms pi bond. This is pi star and this is sigma star. In this fashion we can explain bonding in metal alkene complexes.